This is my 14th video uploaded on your YouTube. This time I will be talking about differential diagnosis of solitary ulcers. You see many ulcerative lesions in your day-to-day practice. Detailed clinical history and examination will definitely point you towards a proper diagnosis. Lesions being solitary eliminates many other lesions which are multiple. Ulcers as differential diagnosis. Today we will discuss about them. If you see this slide at first glance, you will see all these keychains are same, but if you give a closer look, there are variations in each keychain as to the color of the beads, size of the beads, shape of the beads and the color of the thread. Similarly, even an ulcer is solitary, various characteristics differs from each other. Differential diagnosis is comparing similar looking lesions and find characteristic features to arrive at a clinical diagnosis. In very few cases, biopsy is needed and that too for confirmation. In this slide, you will see a solitary ulcer on attached gingiva. Before studying solitary ulcers, you must know what is an ulcer. Ulcer by definition is disruption of surface epithelium, usually extending into corium and with microscopic changes. Surgical incision is also a disruption of epithelium, but it is without microscopic changes. Now, ulcer consists of margin, edge, floor and base as shown in this schematic diagram. For better understanding, margin is a junction between normal epithelium and ulcer. Edge, junction between margin and the floor. Floor is exposed surface of the ulcer consisting of polymorphonuclear leukocytic exudate, and base is on which ulcer rests, which is better felt than seen. I have drawn schematic diagrams to show edges of ulcer and it can be a pointer to the type of ulcer. A. Undermined edge. Here, ulcer destroys subcutaneous tissue faster than skin or mucosa, so there is an undermining. Example, tuberculous ulcer. B. Punched out edges. Here, edge drops down at right angle to surface. Example, gummatous ulcer. Rolled out margins. Edges grow very fast and pile up on normal skin, giving a rolled appearance. It is seen in malignant ulcers. Beaded edges were seen in invasive cellular disease, which become necrotic at center. Example, rodent ulcer or basal cell carcinoma. Now we will take various solitary ulcers one by one and see how to differentiate them with other ulcers. Commonest are traumatic ulcers caused by sharp cusps. Then there are chemical in contact with oral mucosa like hydrogen peroxide or aspirin, or thermal injuries common on palate due to hot food. It can also be seen on lips by accidental touch of hot instrument by a dentist. Here, patient will give a very clear history of the cause and is of a very short duration. Ulcer margins are irregular and painful. It will usually disappear within 7 to 10 days after relieving the cause of ulcer. Example, cuspal smoothing, adjustment of the clasp, etc. In such cases, it is wise to wait for a couple of days for confirmation. Now, look at this ulcer. If you observe this ulcer very carefully, you will see undermining edges due to destruction of subcutaneous tissue early than the superficial epithelium. This ulcer usually is deep, extremely painful with undermined edges and commonly seen on tongue. Lesion usually develops after seeding of tubercular bacilli in a traumatic wound due to coughing. Patient with this type of ulcer usually give history of fever, persistent cough and lymphadenopathy. With all above features into consideration, it is easy to arrive at a diagnosis of tuberculosis and tuberculin tests are carried out for confirmation. Now, this type of ulceration is so characteristic that one of my teachers used to say, you don't have to look at it, this type of ulcer will stare at you. If you see here, margins of the ulcer are everted and fixed to underlying base. It is solitary and usually painless unless secondarily infected. TB ulcers are painful as against this. Size and depth of the ulcer varies, usually unilateral. Lymphadenopathy is present, where lymph nodes are stony hard and fixed. If patient gives history of this long standing ulcer with tobacco habit, usually one must think in terms of malignancy, which it is. Biopsy is indicated. In this case or in this such type of ulcers, follow the dictum, when in doubt, take it out, that is, do biopsy. Now, fungal infections are not common in oral cavity in a reasonably healthy individual. Some oral ulceration is seen in mucormycosis as shown in this slide. Patient is usually medically or immunocompromised. Fungus invades arteries causing thrombosis, ischemia, leading to necrosis and ulceration. These ulcers are deep and usually expose the underlying bone. They are chronic and large in size, so they are very characteristic and easy to identify. Now, as far as the treatment is concerned, it really depends on the etiological factor. In case of trauma, mere removal of the cause like rounding of the offending cusps, adjustment of the appliances, adjusting the impinging part of the denture flange is sufficient. Tubercular ulcers won't heal unless until patient is given anti-tubercular treatment. Same is true for malignant ulcers. Fungal infections are treated by surgical debridement and injectable amphotericin B. Topical anesthetic is usually satisfactory as lidocaine 1% cream or benzocaine, chlorhexidine gluconate gel. Lots of topical emollients are available. I have listed and put pictures of some of them, but leave it to the individual choice as all are more or less same. This is really a small topic. You can call it a first part of a series I may be posting. I am planning multiple ulceration vesiculobulus lesions in my next presentation. Thanks for patiently viewing this video from your busy schedule. If you subscribe my channel, which is free, you will get regular notification whenever I put a new video. If anyhow you miss it, you can access all the videos on my website www.drrajivgadgil.com. Thanks once again and have a great week.